Have you ever wondered if it's true that if we had more trees, we would have more rain? Nowadays, with our weather changing, we often get too much or too little rain. Wouldn't it be great for those of us with expensive water bills and dying crops to get more rain like we used to? Trees are the solution, because it's true, scientists have evidence supporting the widespread perception that trees make rain. By growing more trees, we get more rain. Hi, I'm Dr. Wendy Siebert from Learning from Nature. So why do trees make such a difference? Firstly, the research is showing us that 40% or more of our precipitation comes from evaporation from the surface of the soil and water loss from plants out through their stomata. These are the holes on the undersides of their leaves. Imagine a forest with giant trees and an abundance of other plants growing. You can see the mist as the moisture evaporates, the clouds forming and the rain falling back down into the forests. Forests like the Amazon don't just grow in wet areas, they create the conditions in which they grow, by increasing rainfall and reducing the length of the dry season. Later in the video, we'll look at how two communities benefit from trees. The second reason why trees make such a difference is because reliable rainfall in the middle of Africa, Australia, and other large continents appears to depend on us maintaining relatively intact and continuous forest cover inland from the coast. How do we know this? Research shows us that for more than 60% of the land surface area in the tropics, air that has passed over extensive vegetation in the preceding few days produces at least twice as much rain as air that has passed over sparse vegetation. This transport of moisture inland is called the biotic pump. And by the way, I've included links to all of the research mentioned in this video in the description below. The third reason why trees make such a difference is that when trees get cut down, there is less water in the landscape for making rain, and wet seasons come later. A good example is in southwestern Australia. Here there is a 750-kilometre fence that was built many years ago to exclude rabbits. The land on the western side of the fence was cleared for agriculture because it got more rain. Where do you think it rains more now? With the trees and other vegetation being cleared at a faster rate than any time in history, do you think getting more rain will incentivize us to protect what forest remains and also get enough of us out planting trees? I think it will if we use these trees to also grow food. Trees can provide an extra layer of fruit, nuts, seeds and other products where we now just grow grass, cereals and vegetables. That's what one Colombian community has done in Central America. They've transformed their severely degraded landscape into over 8,000 hectares of productive forest. They now get 10% more rain, and the forest has provided significant economic opportunities for an impoverished region. These include high-grade resin from pine trees, fruit and palm oil. Another example that I'd like to share with you is from Africa. Since the 1980s, hundreds of thousands of farmers in Senegal, Niger, Mali and Burkina Faso, on the southern fringes of the Sahara Desert, have been naturally regenerating their open woodland landscape. They now get extra food and income from their trees. For example, they extract shea butter from the nuts of the shea trees to supply the cosmetics industry. They also sell fruit from their baobab trees for smoothies, juices and ice creams. as part of a $3.5 billion new export industry. We can all benefit from using these ecological approaches to growing food, improving our income and food security. Better rainfall is just one of the ecosystem services these communities have gained by growing more trees. By all of us skillfully integrating trees as part of our food production, we will also benefit from improved livestock production, because pastures grown under well-designed open tree canopies can capture more solar energy and yield higher than grown in full sun. I explain why here. We'll also get better harvests because of improved nutrient recycling in our soil, and see the links in the description below for more information. And the other last thing that I want to mention is that we'll get more water infiltrating and stored in our soil. And I explain why in these two videos. One is for gardeners and one is for farmers. So let's change the story we tell about trees. Trees are a much better way of increasing rainfall than cloud seeding, than atmospheric zappers and rain rockets.